Let's bring in our science expert, Dirk Verdoorn, for a look at some factors in rock slides. What causes this, Dirk?
Yeah, well, you have this is something that's always going on. We have the heating of the day, the cooling of the night, and then you add in water to the equation, and then you get these big rock slides that are big slabs that can come off the rock. They kind of just shear right off. So we're taking a look here. This is where the latest rock slide happened, and you can see the section of rock and the distance that it had to fall. Again, we're going from just a little bit below 5,800 feet down to about 4,500 feet where it hits, and then it slides down to the valley floor. This is a pretty big piece of rock that fell off. You can see it anywhere between 400 to 500 feet in length. So that's much bigger than the one that we had on Wednesday, and you can see that it leaves off. Now what happens, you have this area that's exposed, the white rock, that's the fresh rock that's being exposed to the air, and you can see the rocks surrounding it in the areas of darkness that are associated with that. That's all because of the water. Again, we've had an incredible water year, so a lot of water's been in there, and at freezing temperatures at night turns that water to ice. As ice or as water freezes, it expands, and so that actually helps to create more cracks and make it more unstable. And I think that's just the natural process that's been going on. And you just had this big chunk of rock that was just too much weight to be held up by the area that was supporting it, and it just fell down. And so this is something that has happened, and it always will be happening in that area, and that's a risk that you're going to take if you're going to be there in Yosemite. So